I need to choose my next words carefully. Today I'm doing another Nintendo Switch accessory review. However, before I get to that, I feel that there's some criticism I received in a recent video that I should probably address. This quickly because I do have a product to review today and a giveaway to announce, but I feel that this is important. I recently reviewed a third-party Nintendo Switch controller. In less eloquent terms, I alluded to the fact that the Nintendo Switch is marketed for a younger, more casual audience. Some viewers contested this statement, but honestly, the numbers don't lie. Sources for all this information can be found in the video description, but suffice it to say, the consoles are very obviously marketed for separate demographics. The peripherals designed for the respective consoles accentuate this discrepancy. Nintendo is and always has been the console that anyone can pick up, play, and have a good time. That was the only conclusion that I was attempting to draw. In the video, I know I didn't give this impression, but I actually really like the Switch. Coming from Xbox and PC, however, I prioritize different qualities in my peripherals. Admittedly, I did a poor job of articulating that, and in the process offended some very passionate Switch users. And if you are one of those, I apologize and I commit to be more selective with my vernacular going forward. But today we are looking at the Oortz Nintendo Switch gaming case, and it's got a lot of cool features that I think a lot of Switch users will really appreciate. It features shock-absorbing rubberized material on the outside and on the inside to cushion it in the event of a fall. Portions of the case are made of a hard plastic material to help it keep its rigidity, and it also has a layer of scratch-resistant and slightly opaque plastic. The cutouts for the case are in all the right places. Of course, you have your 3.5mm jack, your charger, and even holes to attach a lanyard. The cutouts for the triggers are placed correctly and don't impede trigger actuation. Unfortunately, the opening for the game card slot is a little bit too small, and it can be a little tricky retrieving a game or putting another game inside the console. For the volume and power buttons, they elected not to have a cutout, and instead there's this soft touch material. I understand why they do that, because those buttons are small and could be hard to reach, but they just don't connect with the physical buttons of the Switch very well. It takes a little getting used to figure out exactly how to maneuver the buttons in order to connect with the device. It has appropriately sized holes on the back and the top of the device, which is important considering the Switch runs an NVIDIA Source Tegra X1 SoC, which can get a little toasty under load, so it's important to leave those vents as unobstructed as possible. It has a kickstand on the back, which is a good idea and a great feature, but it's not implemented very well here. It feels very flimsy and doesn't seem to hold up very well if you accidentally touch it. It seems most steady when it's laying almost completely flat, but that's not the most comfortable way to use it. I think it would have been better just to use the Switch's built-in kickstand and just put in a cutout there, and if you did it that way, then you'd be able to access the memory card slot. Right now, you have to take off the case if you want to get to that. The game storage is this case's killer feature, so if you completely open that kickstand, it will reveal space to store 5 of your favorite games. And that's really convenient because you can keep them with you and leave the cases to the games back at home. My experience with the case was generally a positive one. It's fairly easy to get on and off. I found the easiest way to do it is to take the Switch and put it down in the bottom first and then snap the top over. It's a pretty simple process. Concave grips on the back make it more comfortable than just using the bare Switch on its own, and it makes the console easier to hold and less likely to be dropped. It doesn't make the console too bulky. Now, believe it or not, I can actually fit a naked Switch in some of my jean pockets as it is. Using this case, I was no longer able to do that. Considering the features and the protection you get, it doesn't make the console too big, but keep in mind, there may be some places you were able to fit your Switch before that you might not be able to now. One of those is the docking station, the one that connects to your television. Obviously, with the case on there, it will not fit there. So it's not really that big of a deal considering you're really only going to be using the case when you go out and about, and it's not going to be on your docking station. But just keep in mind, every time you retrieve or place the Switch on the docking station, you will have to remove the case and put it back on. The Joy-Cons cannot be removed or reattached with the case on the Switch. This is probably the biggest drawback. If I want to remove the Joy-Cons from either side of the console, I have to take off the entire case. Considering the triggers are already exposed so that they can be used, I just don't see how it would have been that big of a deal to remove a little bit of extra protection in order to easily remove the Joy-Cons and place them back on. The Ortz Gaming Switch case is a well-rounded and feature-rich enclosure for under $20. The game storage on the back of the device is particularly helpful, and it's not hard to imagine a scenario where that would really come in handy. With a few minor modifications, I feel this could have been one of the best cases out there for the price. But despite those minor changes, I still give it a solid recommendation, and if you'd like to purchase one for yourself, then you can follow my affiliate links in the video description. If you want to see more Switch-related content at the risk of me offending you, possibly, then let me know in the comment section down below. Again, I don't typically look at Switch-related stuff, but if it's something you guys are interested in, then I'm more than willing to take a look. Hopefully I was able to articulate my perspective without rubbing anyone the wrong way. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, we have a giveaway that starts today. It goes through the end of the month. We're giving away a wireless gaming controller by EasySMX. If you want to know my full thoughts and review on the controller, then you can follow that card right there. It'll take you to the review. The winner will be emailed directly on or around July 1st, and the contest is open to all of my viewers in the US and Canada. So sorry to my international viewers. I'll let you know next time we have a worldwide giveaway going on. You can also purchase the controller if you're too impatient to wait to the end of the month to see if you've won. Well, thanks again for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next one.